Good morning, students of class 10. You are welcome back to the e-classes now. Let us continue our lesson in economics. We are doing money and credit. And here, the loan activities. This is the subtitle. Loan activities of the banks. So in what process the bank will provide loan and how they manage the banking system. Here we'll learn a little bit, then we can have some idea and we can learn. So now here there are altogether 6 points I have written over here. Number one, we'll go through this properly one by one and listen carefully. What do banks do with the deposits which they accept from the public? Here is a question. What do banks do with the money they accept from the people who deposit the money in the bank? Those who have got the accounts in the bank, they will deposit their surplus money, extra money in the bank. What do banks do with this money? So now, banks have the mechanism at work. They have certain mechanism, a certain process, certain methods, how to run the banks. They have a mechanism to do the work in the bank. So now here, number two, banks keep a small amount of 15% of their deposit. Within a day, the money which is deposited by the depositor, they keep only 15% of the money in the bank for their day-to-day needs. And the remaining money, the remaining 85%, they will provide to other borrowers who come for loans. So now you can see that banks keep only a small amount of money, that is 15% of their deposits, as cash to pay the depositor. If a person goes to the bank to withdraw the money, naturally they must have the money. From that 15%, they provide the money to the depositors. Suppose the persons who might come to withdraw the money during the day, at any given day, at any time of the day or on any day, so the bank will provide the money to the depositors who want to withdraw the money from this 15%. The 15% money is as the working cap, money, you can say that, turnover. So now here, number three, there is a huge demand for loans. Naturally, there is a huge demand for loans for various economic activities. People want to get loans. People seek loans from the bank. So various people, for various activities, they wanted loan from the banks. So the banks make use of the deposits, that 85%, remaining 85% which they have. The bank make use of the deposits to meet the loan requirements of the people. The people who come there in the bank for loan, so the bank will provide the loan to those people who want the loan from the bank from that 85%, remaining 85%. So now, to meet the loan requirements of the people. Number four, in this way, banks act as a mediator. So banks act as a middleman. They receive the money from the people who have surplus money and provide the money as loan to the people who want the funds for various economic activities. So in this way, banks act as a mediator. Mediator between between those who have surplus funds, that is depositors, after meeting their day-to-day requirements, the surplus money they deposit in the bank. They are depositors. They have their own bank account in that. So depositors and those who are in need of funds, that is borrowers who seek loan. So in this way, the bank charges high interest rate on loan. So when the bank provides loan to a person who wants loan, the bank will charge high interest rate. And then what they offer to the depositors? Suppose when I deposit a money, the bank will provide me 5% interest. Suppose I have a savings account, bank will pay me 5%. And when that bank provide loan to other people, they will charge 15%. So there is a difference of 10%. So 10% is their interest. So bank charge high interest rate on loan than what they offer to the depositors. So the difference in interest, just now I have said that the difference in interest to the depositor and to the seeker of the loan. So difference of interest is their main source of income. That is their income, and with that income they manage the banking system. They have to pay to the workers who work in the banks, and they have to maintain electricity, security, everything. They manage with that difference of interest, with that. That is their income. So in this way, banking system works. So now this is all about the loan activities of the banks. In this way, they keep only 15%, remaining 85% they provide as loan. And we have to learn about the interest. They charge high interest to the borrowers than what they offer to the depositors. So the difference of interest is their main income, and with that income they manage the banking system. So in our next class to be continued, so we have next part, two different credit situations. So two type of credit situations the bank face, and we'll learn about that in our next class. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for your attention as well as your presence and being with me in the class. So that's all. Thank you very much.